Hey guys, welcome back to another video where we will be talking about another debate in regards to another human species. If you have watched our videos, you will probably be familiar with the name Australopithecus afarensis since we have mentioned this species in several videos. Australopithecus afarensis lived about 3.85 to 2.95 million years ago and is one of the longest-lived and best-known early human species. Remains of more than 300 individuals, along with the famous Lucy specimen, which we have specifically described in one of our videos, have been uncovered by paleoanthropologists. Australopithecus afarensis is thought to be more closely related to the genus Homo, including the modern human species Homo sapiens, whether as a direct ancestor or a close relative of an unknown ancestor, than any other known primate from the same time. The species we will be discussing here today, besides Australopithecus afarensis, is known as Homo antiquus, a species only a few people have heard of. Keep in mind, we are referring to a species of the scientific genus Homo, not the believed human race originating from somewhere in the Milky Way galaxy. Now, in 1984, American paleoanthropologist Walter Ferguson decried Australopithecus afarensis as a species, saying that it is a species of the genus Homo, calling it Homo antiquus. Many scientists went against this, but some did go on watching. So let us see if this is a find or a folly. In 1984, Walter Ferguson of Israel's Tel Aviv University declared that Australopithecus afarensis wasn't a real species. At the time, the known fossils of Australopithecus afarensis, like most, came from the site of Hedar in Ethiopia and Laetoli in Tanzania. The vast majority of the hominins found at Hedar have been attributed to Australopithecus afarensis on the basis of their dental and nathic similarities to specimens from Laetoli. But there was a lot of physical variation among the bones in this combined collection, although many anthropologists thought the diversity was simply due to size differences between male and female members of the species. Ferguson, however, believed the bones actually represented more than one species and argues that the discovery of several hominoid fossils in Hedar, Ethiopia is a part of a new species, Homo antiquus. Based on the size and shape of the molars, Ferguson concluded that some of the larger jaws at Hedar matched those of Australopithecus africanus, a species that had only been found in South Africa. And based on his observation, other jaws in the collection had smaller, narrower, Homo-like teeth, and he said that the roughly 3-million-year-old fossils were too ancient to fit with any of the previously described members of the genus Homo. So Ferguson created a new species and named it Homo antiquus. Ferguson's theory of species splitting had a more solid suggestion than we thought, which is if Australopithecus and Homo species had lived side by side for hundreds of thousands of years, it was unlikely that Australopithecines were the direct ancestors of the species Homo. I mean, I don't really know if I support this find, but from the looks of it, almost 30 years later, Australopithecus afarensis is still around and few people have ever heard of Homo antiquus. This means Ferguson's work must not have been that convincing. His work isn't so much controversial as it is not widely supported. But Smithsonian magazine noticed this species splitting theory and in December of 2012 rated Homo antiquus as one of the four human ancestors most likely to be ignored. As we all know, the science behind human evolution during the Pleistocene era is full of theories, gaps and knowledge, and many liberal hypotheses. In conclusion, Ferguson's attempt to change the widely known phylogenetic tree interpreted as a folly today, but could it be reinterpreted as a find if there is additional evidence found in Hadar to back his theories? I don't know, guys, but you have to tell me what you think of this in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching. For more interesting videos, do subscribe to our channel and do not forget to support us by liking our videos and turning on the notification bell. Till then, this is Halabella and see you soon in our next video.